The big question, though, is should you learn Java?
This is one of the questions that comes up a lot. Everybody makes claim that Java is dead. Java 1.0 was released in 1996.
Java, the new COBOL.
But at the end of the day, I would never want to write Java. Much rather write Go.
What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. In this video, I want to talk to you about a topic which comes up pretty much every single year. So, apparently Java is dead again. Every single year we have this conversation where people say that Java is outdated, Java is verbose, Java is too difficult to learn, and nobody uses Java. Well, if that was the case, why would Google, Netflix, AWS, and a bunch of other Fortune 500 companies be still using Java? And yet, if we look at, for example, this index in here, so I don't even know how to pronounce this. I think it's Tiob or Tiob or something like that. If you know how to pronounce this, please let me know. But this in here is a programming community index, which indicates the popularity of a programming language or programming languages. The index is updated once a month. The ratings are based on the number of skilled engineers worldwide, courses, and third-party vendors, popular websites such as Google, Amazon, Wikipedia, Bing, and more than 200 others are used to calculate these ratings. If you look at Java, so let's just strictly focus on Java, and we'll talk about some other languages later. Have a look, Java, so 2024 was number 4, and then 2025, this was updated just recently. It's still number 4. Obviously, Java has been having a decline over the last few years. And in fact, if I scroll down in here, they have a really nice graph where you can see. So Java, so back in 2000, so in here, 2002, have a look. Java was quite dominant. So everyone was using Java, was quite popular. But you can see throughout the years that it's been declining, kind of declining. So you know, it declined around 2005 or 2004, and then it grew, and then it went back, and then you can see that it's been going down, and then here there was a surge, going down, surge, and then a bit of a surge, and then going down, and you can see that maybe there's a surge, because obviously Java is not dying. So look at this survey from Stack Overflow, about 65,000 people from 185 countries. So if we look at technology, for example, in here, and let me just zoom in a little bit so you can see everything. So here, check this out. So we have Java in here as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So obviously this is a different survey, but you can see that Java is not really like Ruby, for example. So if we're saying a language is dying, we're talking about Lua, we're talking about Ruby, not Swift, I would say. Swift is not dying. So if Java is really dying, nobody told the Fortune 500. Seriously, and someone has to tell them. Now, I would really love to understand where this conversation comes from. Is it whether people that come from boot camps or people that just learn Python, JavaScript, and they find that Java is a very difficult language to learn? I really don't understand where all of this negativity comes from, because think about it, right? All of these companies, they use Java to power their systems. When people start saying that Java is hard, for example, so people usually, if you go to a boot camp, they most likely be using, I think, Ruby. I've heard, you know, boot camps using Ruby, which I don't even know why they teach Ruby these days, or Python, or, you know, just JavaScript, because obviously you've got Node. But if you think about computer science, for example, so majority of the universities around the world, they will either choose Java, C++, and some they will choose C, but it's either going to be Java or C++. And I was having a chat with Mohammed. I went to, what's the name of that university that I went to have a talk? Imperial. Yes, I went to Imperial and I said, what programming language that you guys use? And I thought he was going to say C++. But when he said majority of the department, they use Java, I was still, wow, so Java is still a thing. So even back in the days when I went to university, that's the first language that I use, Java. And the beauty that I would say, and I always recommend people to learn Java as their, you know, first programming language, because one, you don't have to deal with allocating, deallocating memory. But the other thing is, yes, Java can be cumbersome. I don't know if it's cumbersome. People say that it's cumbersome. Java can have a lot of stuff when it comes to the syntax. But if you learn Java, learning Python, JavaScript, Golang, and all of these other programming languages is just very easy to pick up. However, if you learn, for example, Python and then you want to learn Java, then that could be a different story. So in my opinion, Java is a solid language. You know, people use Java in production. Java is mainly used in the enterprise world where the community has been established, the frameworks, the libraries, and you can rely on Java to power up your entire business. So even microservices. So we've got, you know, frameworks such as Spring Boot, which is an amazing framework for building APIs and microservices. People are using Java because it's solid. The frameworks are there. You don't have to reinvent the wheel. Things have been tested for years, right? So Java is here to stay, guys. I'm really sorry to say that because I'm not even sorry. No, I wouldn't be. Why would I be sorry? Like, Java is not even my favorite programming language. And when I see stuff like this where people say, oh, Java is dying, you should learn another programming language, it's all crap. Seriously, it is all crap. Comment down below. I would love to know what you think about this topic because, yeah, every single year this conversation comes up. Don't get me wrong. Languages such as Python, Golang, Rust, and all of these new, shiny, even Kotlin as well, right? So they are really great languages. They are becoming popular, but they're not replacing Java. So their goal is not to replace Java. Kotlin, for example, it is mainly used for the Android world, Android development. Yes, some people are using it to replace Java, but you'll see that some people, when they try to replace it with Java, they'll find so many challenges, they even go back and just use Java, to be honest, right? So I would say be an engineer who's open-minded, be someone that is always wanting to use the right programming language for the right job. So companies usually, they don't just use one programming language for building applications. You know, they use various different programming languages and each has its own purpose. You might have, for example, maybe the core of the backend written in Java, for example, but then you might have different tools, microservices written in Golang, some stuff to do with infrastructure, maybe JavaScript or Python. So in my previous role, we used like JavaScript, Python, Golang, which was then the one that we were adopting the most. So just use the right tool for the right job and don't just be like, yeah, I'm just going to learn this language or this language. A programming language is just a tool, to be honest, just a tool to solve a particular problem. And what I want you to do is to try to think like an engineer and not about, oh, I'm not going to use Java because Java, public static void main. This is horrible. But anyways, I'm going to leave it here. If you enjoyed this video, smash the like button. Comment down below. Let me know. Seriously. So for now, I'll see you in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.